Hi, and welcome to the Twisted Stitcher podcast. Today is Tuesday, July 7th, 2015, and this is episode 18. I've got a title for this one, Mojo, Mojo, Where Art Thou, Mojo? So it's been a little bit. It's been a little over a month, I believe, since I have come to see you. But I'm here! Yay! It's been a very busy month. It's been a very unproductive knitting and spinning month, but you know what? I am A-okay with that, and you should be too. There should not be any pressure with crafting, but we'll get more to that later. So, how have you guys been? Hopefully you've been good. Trying something new and different this time. I am recording on my iPhone. I knew it's been a little bit since I've gotten to you guys, and I don't have a lot of time to record, but I figured let's just go the simple route and try the iPhone. So hopefully picture is good, sound is good, background is back to semi-usual. Yeah, hopefully this room will be changing a little bit soon and will be morphing into more of a relaxing crafting space instead of a working space. That's part of, I think, why my mojo is gone, is I feel stressed out in my, what should be my happy place. So, yeah. So let's dive right into it. I don't have any whips to show you. I have not done any knitting in the last month. I don't think I've knit even a single stitch. I just don't have any projects on my needles that I'm thrilled with. I like my invisibility cloak that I was working on, but I just don't want to knit. So, but that's okay. I do have one small spinning project in the works on my new sidekick. I think if you guys remember the last time I talked to you, I told you that I had a shacked sidekick on the way. Well, it got here, and I love it. It still needs to be broken in a little bit. Things are a little tight, but I think the more that I use it, it's gonna really wear in and work well for me. So what I'm working on is some of my own fiber. It's actually a colorway that I fell in love with as soon as I dyed it. I had dyed it up for Fiber Field Day, and I secretly had hoped the whole time that it wouldn't sell because I loved it so much. So it is some super fine merino. I've had it in this little clear bag. You can actually see it pretty good in there. It's bright, fun colors. It's got aqua and orange and yellow and some bright pink and just super, super, super fun colors. So this is spinning up really, really nice. This is kind of a cool bag because I can hang it on the side of my wheel and just leave the fiber in there, and it's kind of protected from the doggies and such. So, yeah, that is some of Twist Fiber Studio Superfine Merino. I'm calling it the Sydney colorway because the colors just totally remind me of Australia. So this is it on the bobbin. Boy, that light is bright. Hey, that's a little better. It's spinning up super, super, super fine. Let me see if I can find my end. So let's show you. So this is what it's looking like. That's kind of the aqua bit. But yeah, it's lots of pretty, pretty, pretty colors. I'm excited to be spinning it, but as you can see, I don't have very much done. What I did with this is I just split the braid in half down the whole length of it, and I'm going to spin it. I'll probably spin it all on one bobbin and then Navajo ply it, chain ply it. But I'm not totally sure. I don't really have a plan. I just wanted to get something on the wheel and get some spinning done. So yeah, fun stuff. Pretty bright, fun, summery colors. I don't have any FOs. I haven't had any FOs in a while, but this is sort of my PSA of the day. If you don't have any finished objects and you haven't finished anything in a while, it's okay. There's no knitting police. Nobody's going to come and get you if you don't finish something. I think all too often, especially for those of us that watch podcasts, we feel a lot of pressure to knit like the wind and knit all the things and get a million things done. And that if we're not finishing projects and getting stuff off our needles, that we're somehow inadequate. It's not true. Not finishing things is okay. Having things on the needles for a long time is okay. This is supposed to be something fun and enjoyable. And when it becomes not fun and not enjoyable, that's not good. So guys, don't feel pressure. I know Michelle, my stepmom, and I, we talk about it a lot, how, you know, you watch these podcasts and you see some people finishing 5, 6, 8 projects in a week. And I mean, that's awesome. That is so great that they have that kind of mojo, but I just don't. And I'm learning to be okay with that. So yeah. So you guys, you're not going to see a whole lot of finished projects on my podcast. When I do, it's going to be a huge celebration because that's kind of a big milestone for me. I lose patience very quickly. I lose interest very quickly. I find I do best with like one skein projects. So yeah, guys, just keep it fun. Keep it, do what makes you happy. You are not out there to please anybody else but yourself. So with that being said, I'm going to show you someone else's finished object. my wonderful, awesome stepmom, Michelle, was so kind and so generous to do some knitting for me. I have a very dear, special, close friend to me. Her name is Diane. She is her official title is Entrepreneurial Outreach Coordinator at my college's Small Business Center. She basically has been my mentor, my coach, my special awesome somebody throughout the Student Business Incubator program that I've participated in over the last year. She also was a Kickstarter backer. Diane is not a knitter, however, so what is she going to do with yarn? Well, not a whole lot. So I asked Michelle if she would please knit for me. So Diane's favorite color is purple. She pledged for one of the surprise perfect pair sets. So I made for her this beautiful purple bag with the birds on it. I actually called this one Bird Song. So she hasn't seen it yet. I hope she loves it. I'm going to be going to see her on Monday. And what I did was I dyed up yarn to match. This is the Ashland Sport Weight yarn. So Michelle, if you're watching, you need to go correct it. It's not the Fairview Fingering like I thought. What I had Michelle knit was the Age of Brass and Steam shawl. This is by, I can't remember. Orange Flower Yarn? No? Maybe? I don't remember. But this turned out so great. So this is with one skein of Ashland Sportweight yarn. She got 1, 2, 3, 4 full sections and the little eyelet trim. I've still got to weave in the ends, but that's no big thing. But I really wanted to show you guys this because I don't think you have seen a finished object with one of the perfect pair sets. So there is the bag and the finished object. So you can see how well the yarn and the bag matches. I'm so pleased with this, so happy with how this turned out. I know Diane is going to love it because every time I would wear one of my little shawlettes to the office, she would gush over it. She's one of those people that really appreciates knitwear, so perfect fit, except for the ends, got to weave those in. So I'm going to be going to give this to her on Monday. I really like this. Maybe this will inspire me to get my mojo back and knit one of my own. So yeah, this is the Age of Brass and Steam shawlette. You can really knit this in any weight. It's really more of a shawl recipe. Some sad news is Diane actually recently found out that her position was being eliminated. So we've kind of had some times lately, just kind of working through it. She does so much for the college, and I don't think anybody really knows the scope of her reach. She not only helps with the student business incubator program, but she also goes into the classroom to talk about entrepreneurial opportunities for students. She hosts two camps over the summer, for 1 week for middle schoolers and 1 week for high schoolers. She is one of the Small Business Center mentors and counselors there. So when someone comes in and needs advice or help with their own small business, she's there to help them. So it's a hard thing knowing that she's not going to be there. She's a huge resource to the college, and I really was sure to let my opinion about that be heard. I sent a long email to my college's president and to her supervisor and the division chair to let them know that she makes a huge impact in the life of students and that her position is greatly needed. So it's unfortunate when budget cuts and things like that cause positions to be eliminated, especially important positions. I also recently learned that my college is planning to shut down the local campus to me where the Small Business Center is, all based on budget constraints. I understand budgets, but it sucks. There's no better way to put it. My college was gifted this property and these buildings back in the year 2000 by a local manufacturing facility. The college received two very large buildings. The building where the Small Business Center is called the Technology Commercialization Center, TCC. And it's, I think, 200,000 square feet, so it's a huge property. The land itself is 37 acres. I feel like the college is making a lot of decisions based on development potential. There's a brand new grocery store being built across the street, and the entire area is just building and growing. So my personal opinion is that I feel like the college just sees dollar signs. And they're really giving up a good asset to the college. Land like that in Asheville is hard to come by. And the college just has never fully utilized that campus's potential. And I feel like it's a bad decision to sell it off and to close it down. So guys, stay in the know with what's going on with your local, you know, your local government property and land and community college land. So yeah, it's a kind of a sad thing. I'm just one voice of many, and hopefully myself and some of the other small businesses that work closely with the Small Business Center, we're going to go before the Board of Trustees and let our voices be heard and let them know that we rely on that space, the resources available there at the TCC. And yeah, so just a whole bunch of shakeups in the last month. Some good, some not so good. So that's a finished object. Yay! Moving along. So I have a tiny bit of stash enhancement that I didn't even have to spend money for. Isn't that the best kind? So I have long participated in the Blue Mountain Handcrafts and Clay Sheep group in Ravelry. They have a really cool forum there called the Round Robin D-Stash, which basically is the first person put something up for D-Stash that they didn't really want anymore. Anybody else in the thread can say, me, please, I want that in my stash. So they claim it, the first person mails it off to them, and then the next person, whoever claimed it, puts up something else for offer. It can be anything fibery related, spinning fiber, yarn, tools, notions, anything like that. And it just keeps going and going and going like a round robin does. So I've participated in that several times and it's so much fun. But what I recently participated in when the same group was called the Traveling Treasure. The way it works is you had to sign up for the treasure and the coordinator mapped everybody out. Most everybody was located in the U.S. And the coordinator put four items in a flat rate shipping envelope and sent it off to the first person. That person could pull out up to three items and replace them with three items. So I think there were like 25 participants, something like that. It was so much fun. And just to see it go to everybody and what they picked out, and then the next person what they would pick out. The cool part was that it was a surprise. When it came to you, you had no idea what could be in it. So when it came to me, it had actually morphed from an envelope to a box. So it was getting a little bit sizable, and we needed to get it back down to envelope size. So what I took out of the package was this gorgeous fiber from Greenwood Fiber Works. So I'll have to kind of do it like that. This is Painted Sparkle Roving. It's 4 ounces, 60% Polwarth, 20% silk, and 20% nylon. So the nylon is sort of the sparkly bit. That light is so bright. Sorry, you guys. Beautiful, beautiful fiber. Super, super soft. This is the Victoria colorway. So, oh, I love this. I can't wait to spin it. I'm so glad to finally be excited to buy some fiber. So I picked that out. I also picked out, have you guys seen this? Nunoco? I'm not sure how to say it. Sorry for the crinkling. This is 21 micron merino. There are 10 different colors. I think there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yep, 10 different colors. 10 grams of each. So it's 100 grams of merino. Looks like comb top. This is the Rock Pool colorway. You can kind of see the sticker there. Nunoco. So this is really cool. I'm excited by this because little 10 gram increments like that, I think could keep my attention better. These apparently come in all different colors. I thought this would look really, really pretty in some sort of a like a striped shawl or scarf or cowl, something like that that's gonna show how the colors stack up. So cool fiber there too. The third thing I picked out is this big ol' honkin' lovely bat. Beautiful, beautiful bat. This is by, if I'm thinking correctly, this is Bonnie, aka Bon Knits. I'm pretty sure she has an Etsy shop, but I'm not entirely positive. So it's kind of like light pastel colors, but rainbow with lots of sparkle. Sparkle, sparkle, sparkle. This in it has Corriedale wool, merino wool, mystery wool, Angelina, and Firestar. I think it's like 3.5 ounces or so. But gorgeous, beautiful, big bat. I don't spin bats near enough, so I'm excited to add this to the stash. I added three lovely things back to the package and sent it on its way to the next person. I thought this could be something really fun to try in our group. If you guys are up for it, let me know. We can coordinate it for maybe later this year when life slows down a little bit. I know summertime for almost everybody is crazy, crazy, crazy. So we'll keep a chat about it and maybe do that in our group. Try it out, see what we think about it. Good way to maybe swap stash around and get some fun new surprises in our stash. The other stash enhancement I have, which if you follow me on Instagram, you saw some pictures. I got a loom. I got a floor loom. It's made by Harrisville Designs. It's a very small, compact floor loom. You can actually see part of it right there. Floor loom folded up in the corner. That's one reason I really wanted the Harrisville Designs loom is because it folds up. The back beam folds up, the front beam folds up. It's only about like yay wide folded up like deep and like 30-ish inches wide, 22 inch weaving width. I think it'll be perfect for all the projects that I want to do. I see myself doing like dish towels, scarves, small wraps, table runners, table what do you call it? Placemats. That's what you call those, placemats. I want to do some bright rainbow colored placemats to match my Fiesta dishes. So that'll be on the loom soon. Weaving is just a very different craft. It's pretty cool. It goes really quick. I started doing some little dish towels, and you can bang out a dish towel in like 30 minutes, maybe less. So yeah, it's fun. It's different. I haven't had much time to play with it lately just because life's been so demanding. But hopefully soon I'll be able to share some weaving ethos with you. So cool stuff. If you want to see what the pictures look like, just hop over to my Instagram feed and you can see several pictures there. You can find me on Instagram as Carolina Spinner also. So that's all the stash enhancement. I hope to have some more stash enhancement coming up soon in the next couple weeks. I am really, 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 really hoping to be able to make it to the SSK Market, which is on Saturday, July 18th in Nashville, Tennessee. For those that don't know, SSK is Super Summer Knit Together. That is put on by Leslie and Laura, hosts of the Knit Girls podcast. It's in Nashville over the weekend of the, I think it was the 15th through the 19th. And it's a huge, huge retreat. I think there's 150 attendees. They have lots of classes. They have a very well curated, awesome vendor market. I really hope I can go. It's just one of those if the stars align kind of things. So if I'm able to go, you guys will see some stash enhancement in a couple weeks. Life updates. So school is going well. I am so close to done. It's not even funny. I have less than a month left. The last day of classes is August 3rd. My classes are kind of tricky this semester. I'm in accounting and, well, let's see, the second accounting class, managerial accounting and macroeconomics. I have figured out that I do not like economics. I don't care for economics whatsoever. I understand that it's important to understand the concepts, but meh. That's the best I can say about that. My economics class, I'm having to do it as an independent study because the accounting class and economics class were offered at the same time on the same days. So, in order to get done on time, this was the only way that I could do both. So, I'm struggling a little bit with some of it because I have a teacher, but it's kind of like not having a teacher. It's all online. I don't have like a physical class meeting that I go to, so it's different. Knowing that I have less than a month is what is getting me through at this point, and I cannot wait to be done. Over the last couple days, I've been doing a little bookkeeping work for my business, Twist Fiber Studio, and the numbers are all looking good. It's shaping up like I won't necessarily need that big girl job after I get done with school. So, yeah, good stuff there. That's about it on that front. I did want to talk to you guys about something new. I am calling it the Fitter Knitter Challenge. I saw Fitter Knitter on Instagram and thought I might borrow that for this. So what the Fitter Knitter Challenge for me is just being more mindful about what I eat, being more mindful about how active or inactive I am, and just trying to get more healthy. I've been a chunky person my entire life, pretty much, and it just kind of sucks. So I'm working on that. I've tried several times in the past, like going sort of all in, really monitoring closely what I eat, being a gym fanatic, and I found that when I go too overboard that direction, I burn out really quickly. So this is just going to be about sustainable lifestyle changes, if you will. My boyfriend's on board with me. If you remember a couple months ago, I told you guys about his new job. It's a little bit more sedentary, and he's noticing he's putting on a few pounds. So, we recently joined a gym. They had a 3-month promotional deal going for the summer where it's 3 months for $99, I thought it would be a good way to get in there and try it out. It's very close to us. It takes us 10 minutes to get there. So yeah, hopefully all will go well. If nothing else, I got some cute new workout clothes and some awesome gym shoes out of it. So what I think I might do is start a thread in the group, where if any of you guys are kind of on the healthier lifestyle transition, we can kind of talk it out, be each other's support system. I did also get a Fitbit. I went with the Fitbit Flex. I had some Staples rewards that needed to be used up, and I also had them price match. So I came out the door with my Fitbit for $20. You cannot beat that. I'm learning very quickly that on weekdays, I'm not very active. On weekends, when my boyfriend is home and we're out and about and doing stuff, I'm getting a lot more steps in. So I've got to improve that. Hopefully with the gym, that will change a lot. So yeah, cool. Fitter knitter. Awesome. Are you going to be a fitter knitter with me? Let's find out. In other happenings, I had a birthday. Yay! My birthday was this past Friday, July the 3rd. I turned 28 awesome years old. The birthday was fairly uneventful. On Thursday, I spent the day with my mom, and myself, my boyfriend, my mom, and my stepdad all went out to dinner for seafood, and it was so good. Oh my gosh. We got this huge, like, seafood feast. It was like one of those feeds everybody at the table and probably your neighbors too kind of deal. But we had crab and lobster and scallops and shrimp, and oh, it was so good. Then on Friday, on my actual birthday, my boyfriend had to work like half a day, which sucked. That always sucks when your significant other has to work on your birthday. But he got done with his work and we went shopping for a little bit. He took me to the mall, to Ulta, and I got the Urban Decay Naked on the Run palette. I should have brought it in here to show you guys, but it's really cool. It has everything for like a full face makeup look in it. I think it's got five eyeshadow colors, blush, bronzer, mascara, eyeliner, and lip gloss in it. Really, really pretty. Totally my colors. So glad he got it for me. Thanks, babe. Then we went to, where'd we go? Oh, we went to the new outlet mall here in Asheville and just did a little bebopping, shopping around. He got some new workout clothes from the Under Armour outlet, which was pretty cool. They were having a big sale. And we went out to lunch with my dad and my stepmom, Michelle. We went to the Japanese place, and that was really tasty, too. That night, I don't think, did we go out to dinner anywhere? I don't think we did. I think we were still so full from lunch that we didn't even go out to dinner. We went to have ice cream. We went to many favorite local ice cream places. It's in Mills River, North Carolina. It's just like 20, 30 minutes away from Asheville. And it's all like locally raised cows. So it's local dairy, locally made in-house ice cream. It was so good. I had the Butterfinger, a scoop of Butterfinger, and a scoop of peanut butter. I love peanut butter. So that was good. It was just a fun birthday. Just relaxed, chilled out, didn't do a whole lot. Then the next day, Saturday, which was the 4th, we went to a big cookout at my grandparents' house. They're in from Florida. So that was a lot of fun, and stopped on the way home and watched the fireworks and came home and went to sleep. So it's been kind of uneventful, between work and school and life. It just, you know, it kind of keeps you busy and keeps you hopping. So yay. Moving on along, we have a contest to draw for. Do you guys remember? It's been so long, right? So our contest was for the fiber sampler. It is 16 different breeds of fiber. So originally in the post I said I was going to do a half ounce of each breed, but I'm just going to go ahead and go with the ounce because I already have this ready to send out to the winner. Vanna White, please. Oh. So there are 16 varieties of fiber in here, 1 ounce of each, so it's a pound of fiber. There's everything from Shetland to Superfine Merino to Superwash Merino Nylon Blend, Blueface Leicester Silk Blend, some interesting fibers like Masham and Gotland and Targi. So if you are a spinner, this is a good way to figure out what kind of fibers you really like. So in the contest thread, we had 8 entries. If you remember, I asked you guys to tell me about your favorite memory, either from graduation or vacation. So let us see here. We had there were 9 posts in the thread, the first one being me. So we're going to go to random.org. We're going to go 2 through 9. Let me try it this way. Hey, there we go. 2 through 9. Generate. The result is number 9, right? 9, upside down, around, and backwards. Yes, number 9. Let's see who number 9 is. Post number 9 is Claudie. Or I think that's Claudie. Yeah, Claudia from Mason City, Iowa. She says, and good job, Claudia. You posted almost on the last day. She says, so many great vacation memories. One that stands out is a driving trip from Minnesota to Gettysburg, camping out in Chambersburg, and spending 2 days touring the battlefields with our teenage son, who is a Civil War buff. Then on to Philadelphia and more wonderful history. The fiber is beautiful. Awesome! So, Claudia, yay! Hooray! Congratulations! If you will PM me on Ravelry, I am Carolina Spinner. Let me know what your address is and I will get your prize out to you. Congratulations! Yay! Awesome! All right, so July, we have a new contest. I'm so excited. Okay, we have our very first podcast prize sponsor. Yay! Our sponsor this month is Allie Coffee. She is Crafty Allie on Ravelry and Instagram. She is an awesome pattern designer. If you have never seen any of Allie's patterns, you are missing out. She is like a pattern mastermind. Allie has very generously given us a free copy of her new ebook called All the Azzles. Allie has designed us a collection of 3 different shawl patterns called, they're all Azzle words. So the first one is, there are 3 different ones, Dazzle, Razzle, and Frazzled. So I'm going to show you pictures of them. Bear with me. So this is Dazzle. Isn't that pretty? I want to knit it. This is Razzle. Razzle's really pretty too. It has a contrasting edge color. Razzle. There we go. That's good. And then the last one is Frazzled. This one's really cool. It's got like drop stitches. So, it's coming. So this is Frazzled. Isn't that cool? All right. So what do you got to do to win this ebook? Well, there are actually several ways in which you can win. We're going to shake things up a little bit. So, you can actually get multiple entries for this month's contest. The first way, and everybody is eligible for this entry, all you have to do is go to Allie's pattern store and tell me which of the Azzles is your favorite. Is it razzle? Is it dazzle? Or is it frazzled? So, just post in the contest thread with whichever azzle is your favorite. Another way that you can get an entry is to knit any of Allie's patterns during the month of July. So, even if you have one on the needles already, as long as you finish it in the month of July, you're eligible for an entry. She has the 3 shawl patterns. Then she also has a hat pattern. No, sorry, 2 hat patterns. She just came out with an awesome new hat pattern. This new hat pattern is totally free. So you can get this entry without spending any money as long as you knit the hat. So the new hat is called Flotsam. And it's really cute. I want to knit one so bad. So it calls for DK weight yarn. Isn't that cool? It's just like a simple pattern. So variegated yarns will work great with this. Totally free. Go and download it and knit it. It's going to be awesome. The other hat is called Make It Work. And it's really pretty too. So you can knit any of Allie's 5 patterns and get another entry. All you've got to do for that, go in the prize thread, share a picture of what you knit. You can whip up either of those hats in like 2 or 3 days. Awesome. There's another way, though, that you can get another entry. With this, if you buy any of Allie's patterns during the month of July, you get another entry. Just post in the thread that, hey, I bought Make It Work. And that gets you an entry into the contest. The even better part about this is that Allie has given us a super generous coupon for 25% off any of her individual patterns. So say like the Make It Work hat, it is $3.50. It's already dirt cheap. Then you can take 25% off on top of that. How awesome is that? So buy any of her patterns and that gets you an additional entry per pattern even. So if you buy Razzle and Frazzled, take the 25% off, and that gets you 2 entries into the contest. Awesome. To get that 25% off, the coupon code is TwistedStitcher25. That's also going to be in the show notes for this month's episode and in the contest thread. So 3 different ways to get an entry. Let's say you tell me which pattern is your favorite. You knit both of her hats. That's 3 points. You had to buy the 1 hat pattern and you buy Razzle. That's 5 entries into this contest. That's really cool. That gives you a super good odd of winning. So, as usual, our regular contest rules apply. You do need to be a member of the group. Usually it's just 1 post per person, but this time I want you to put it in separate posts. So for each entry that you're claiming, put it in a separate post for me and I'll do all the back end stuff. The contest is going to close on July 31st. What I'll actually do is I'll give you a little bit of time. Like I'll close it on like August 7th to give you time to, if you're knitting something, so that you can finish your knitting, wash it and block it and get FO pictures and all that jazz and get them loaded into the thread. So finish your knitting by July 31st, but get your picture posted by August 7th. And then I'll announce the winner in an August episode. Because at this point, I can't promise anything. I can't promise 2 episodes a month because life is just too crazy. So it'll either be in the August 15th episode or September 1st episode, depending on how life is going at the time. So yeah, yay. Thank you so much, Allie, for your generous sponsorship this month. If you are a pattern designer, an Andy Dyer, a bag maker, or any other fabulous crafting person, and you would like to sponsor the podcast for a month, please get in touch with me. We would love to help promote your goodies and also welcome your prize, whatever you'd like to give away. There's no cost to participate. So yay. So yeah, that I think that about brings us to the end. We are 40 minutes in. Yeah, so the last thing I wanted to mention was sort of the podcast. As you have likely noticed, I've been coming to you with sort of some irregular frequency lately. I'm trying very hard to not pod fade. Up until recently, it's been hard for me to record a podcast without having anything to show you. I feel like that I'm a crafter fail if I don't have knitting or spinning or crafting to talk to you guys about. But I'm learning to sort of change my mentality on that. Like I was saying earlier, crafting should be fun and should be no pressure. And it's okay if I don't have something to show you guys every single week or 2 weeks. As long as I'm coming to you and talking to you about what makes me happy that hopefully makes you happy, that's, hey, everybody's happy. So I guess that wraps everything up this episode. Thank you so much for sticking with me. I really appreciate you guys coming back and watching new episodes. Remember that you can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Carolina Spinner. You can find the podcast at twistedstitcherpodcast.com and youtube.com/twistedstitcher1. Hopefully you'll soon be able to find us on iTunes as well. I'm still working on that, but just haven't had a lot of time to devote to it. You can also find my shop, Twist Fiber Studio, at twistfiberstudio.com or on Etsy, twistfiberstudio.etsy.com. So thank you guys again for tuning in today, and I hope you have a great couple of weeks. I will be likely coming back to you on August 1st. So thank you guys so much. I hope you guys have a good couple 3 weeks, and we'll talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye.